Hello and welcome to the Marty Crane Chair. Are we on? We're on quick check. So currently, Mr. Clarachk is outside and he's spraying bugbee gun on the garden, and I'm hiding in the house because every year I manage to poison myself because, well, in about half an hour when he's done, I'll hide in here for a little while longer. And then I'll go outside to grill, and I'll forget that he's put poison on everything, and I'll sit right in the middle of it. And then I'll be sick for the next 2 days. So I'm just going to hang out in the house for a little while and just come on to say hello, give you a quick little giggle about something that I've just done. But first, and hopefully I don't forget to share the giggle with you, first I want to tell you that I'm currently recovering from a most fantabulous weekend. We had our first annual company picnic slash barbecue slash excuse to get completely shit-faced on the business expense. So we had invited everybody over to the house, clients, etc., threw a big barbecue, queued up some fantastic music, set up tents in the backyard, showed off our recent gardening adventures and rebuilds, and showed off the computer shop. So the idea was to get them in, give them some free food, good music, great conversation, let them wander around the computer shop, and hopefully it'll generate some more business, because the idea is to let people know, because it's not obvious to some people, that we don't just fix computers. Or I shouldn't say we, I should say he, as in Mr. Clarachk. He is an electronics genius and can fix anything. If you had built yourself a death ray, actually no, not built yourself, bought yourself a death ray and it broke. I say not built because if you built it yourself and it broke, you would know how to fix it. If you bought a death ray and it broke, you could bring it here and Dean, Nerdboy, would figure out what the hell was wrong and would fix it. So yeah, again, the idea was to get them in the shop and show them that he also does other things that are of the electronics assortment. He doesn't just fix computers. So the barbecue was absolutely fantastic, and it actually, we had it on Friday and we over-prepared and overcooked. I was worried that we would run out of food, but we had so much stuff left over, food and beer, that we invited the not dead wood people back. The people that actually stayed, we invited them back yesterday to help polish off the leftovers and the beer. So we picked out another round of music on the iTunes, queued it all up, and had half dozen people over, helped a friend of ours design new bunny hutches for a project that she's venturing out on. She's actually getting ready to send her bunnies out to camp for breeding purposes, and yeah, so that was part of the project for yesterday. So it went so friggin' well. You know, a couple of people came that I was you know, hoping they didn't hang out for too long, and luckily they didn't, because they had a Save the Boobies fest to go to. Now what I mean by that is Bitchface at the cubicle farm has just undergone radiation therapy. She found out that she had breast cancer. Fortunately, I don't know if that's quite the right word, but fortunately for her, she found out that it was stage zero. But she decided to go for the radiation therapy as a preventative measure. So she's just finished her last radiation therapy and she's a complete mess. She's all black and blue and burned, and it's just horrible, and I feel terrible for her. And they went out to celebrate her last therapy, and she planned her Save the Boobies night, actually not she, a friend of hers, on the same night that we had our barbecue. So fortunately for us, most of my office, the cubicle farm animals, were going to Bitch Faces Save the Boobie Fest. So a couple of the important people showed up and stayed for an hour to make an appearance, and then they left to go make their appearance at the Boobie Fest. So the Deadwood left around 8 or 9-ish, because what we did was we used our noggins. We said we're having a barbecue from 6 to 8. And when people said, well, what the hell's going on? Who the hell has a barbecue from 6 to 8 and then kicks people out? We told them in private that, well, it's not really going to end at 8. It's going to go as late as you want to stay. But the idea is, for people that come and are bored out of their skulls or want to go out and do something else on a Friday night and not hang out at our barbecue, we don't want them to feel like they're obligated to stay. So we'll tell them it's from 6 to 8, and anybody that wants to stay and is having a good time can stay. So we ended up hanging out until about 1:30 on Saturday morning. And like I said before, we had such a good time that when we woke up, we decided to start text messaging, calling the people that filled out our company for the remainder of the evening / morning, and invited them back for leftovers. So we had them over again yesterday. And then this morning, we're just kind of futzing about, cleaning up, recovering, designing bunny hutches, and I'm outside playing with my petunias. Now this is the giggle part. The giggle part is I'm examining my petunias. And as most of you know, gardening is still a new thing for me, and I tend to, in most cases, have a black thumb. So I'm seeing yellow leaves on my roses in spots, and I'm freaking out thinking that, you know, I've overwatered them, they've got leaf fungus, it's gonna spread, I'm gonna kill all the rest of my roses. Blah, 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 blah. Then I notice my petunias have black specks all over the leaves, and I'm freaking out. So I run into the house on my laptop, and I'm looking up black eggs, because I'm thinking something laid eggs on my freaking plants, and I need to know how to get rid of these things. So after ridding most of these eggs, I think I'm gonna get an Interruptus Maximus. You see how I panic when I think someone's coming to interrupt my vlog? Yes, I'm being interrupted.
Getting my glasses washed.
Okay,